may have seen our previous video detailing the DME7 device. If not, then you'll find a link in the description to that content, which will tell you everything you need to know about the capabilities of the hardware. But there is one process that I didn't cover in the last video, and that's to show you how to apply a license to your device. This license allows you to expand the capabilities of the DME7, adding additional channels of Dante I/O. I'm going to describe the process that uses our ProVisionaire cloud service, but please be aware that this service isn't available in every region of the world. If you're unsure, then please check with your local Yamaha dealer. So, if we're using the online activation method, this is how we'd begin. It's important to understand how the parts of this process work. So, firstly, you'll have a license that you purchase through your Yamaha dealer. This will be delivered to you as a physical copy at this stage. The DME7 comes from the factory with 64 inputs and 64 outputs. You can expand this in blocks of 64 by 64 until you reach a maximum of 256 by 256, which the DME7 can handle at up to a 96 kHz sample rate. Then we have the ProVisionaire Portal app, which can run on either Android or iOS devices. This can communicate with your hardware and also communicates with the ProVisionaire cloud service, which maintains all the licensing information for your Yamaha devices. Let's start on my laptop, as we'll find it easier to set up the details on the cloud service from here. We'll go to the ProVisionaire cloud website, which can be found at the address shown on the screen now. Once on this site, you'll need to set yourself up with a Yamaha Music ID for Business. This account is personal to you, but it can be linked with multiple devices and organizations, as you'll see soon. Once you're signed up and logged in, you need to first set up an organization. This organization might be your own company, or it might be your client's company. It relates to who will own the license and the device, and access to this organization can be shared with relevant parties. Once you've set up your organization, we can now register your license code. Please note, once you assign a license to an organization, it can't be moved to another organization in the future. This is intentional to maintain security and ownership of licenses. Depending on how you apply the license, you may still be able to move it between devices, but it will always remain within that organization once it's registered. Make sure that your new organization is selected at the top, and then ensure that licenses are selected on the left-hand side. Click the button for plus license code at the top right. This will give you the opportunity to enter the license code from the document that your dealer's provided to you. Once you've entered the code, the system will confirm what type of license it is that you've added. If everything matches up, then we're ready to apply the license. To carry out the rest of this licensing process, your DME7 will need to be on a network that's also accessible by your mobile device. Also, at some stage, your mobile device will need a means of connecting to the internet. In the simplest setup, you'd have everything connected to a single network that has internet access. But in many real-world cases, you may find that you have an isolated network for your DME, and then you connect over a mobile connection, such as 5G, to authenticate with the cloud. Let's look at the process now. So, the DME7 is connected to an isolated network here. I have a Wi-Fi router connected to that network that allows my phone to communicate with the device a little later. On the mobile device, whether it's running Android or iOS, you'll need to connect to a network with internet to download the ProVisionaire Portal app from your App Store. You can then use your Yamaha Music ID for Business to log into the app. During login, you'll be asked to confirm a code as part of the two-factor authentication built into the system. Now, the first screen will ask you to scan QR code. This is a code generated by the DME7 device. So on the DME7, navigate through the menus until it presents you with the QR code. Then scan this using the app. The device will be detected. You'll see the model number and serial number along with its current license status. You can actually do this check with any DME7 device to verify the current license installed, even if you don't own that device yourself. You'll see your available licenses shown under the section labelled License Name. You can have multiple licenses ready to activate here. You select the license that you wish to apply, and then you choose one of the two options. You can either activate the license permanently, which will mean that it cannot be removed in the future, or you can choose the option to activate temporarily, which means that in future you could deactivate the license and move it to another device. This could be useful if your device isn't permanently installed at a venue, and it could save you some money on license purchases. Once you've selected the correct option, the activation process will happen automatically. So the PV Portal app registers the DME7 details with a cloud service and obtains the license. Then the license can transfer from the PV Portal app to the DME7. Once the transfer is complete, the app will confirm, and on the device you can also confirm what license is now installed. Now your DME7 will have increased capabilities. So, as you've seen here, your DME7 does not need to be connected to the internet for license transfer to occur. The PV Portal app acts as a relay between the cloud service and the device to allow the license to be registered both online and on the hardware. And this process only has to happen once. Hopefully this video has been useful. For other information about the DME7 or the ProVisionaire design software, check out the other videos in this series.